Once again, welcome all of you. In the today's session, we discuss about the DNS. DNS, that means the domain name server. Before discussing going on DNS, one point is very clear. In the today communication, it is important without IP address, nothing communication possible. IP address, normally two types of IP address used in the world. One is the manually directly allotted by the manager. And another IP address, general client like you and I, if I connect to internet, so definitely my devices required IP address. So these IP address automatic allotment by the in the network available by the mechanism, either DHCP server, either DHCP router. At your home, in old time, your modem is normally simple modem. But in the current time, your home Wi-Fi is known as the router Wi-Fi, router modem. So meaning is very clear. Your modem feature of router inbuilt by the software mode. So due to the this, your modem is able to the giving the IP address allotment at the local end, which customer connected to the that modem Wi-Fi. Okay, so that. In this case, your modem is known as the router modem. Before 2006, there is only modem. And if you in 2006 go for the internet, so modem have no facilities of the DHCP. In this case, from the telephone exchange, either BSNL, other ISP, they already in the pre configure your modem, then hand over to you. But today, every modem, even your mobile phone, in the software mode, DHCP facility is available. Okay. So yesterday we discussed about this is your screen. Okay. In this project, this is a router. So LTTC router. How to give the facilities router by the DHCP? So just click on DHCP and check here, enable to show running configuration and now checking here. So what type command here firing in the my DHCP? IP DHCP pool KKSY. Second is the network ID, which network IP given these all computer laptop and what is the gateway? Okay, so these three point is most important. Okay, for the enable DHCP services in the router, just go to the configuration mode, firing these three commands one by one, automatically your router DHCP service is on. In the real world, already one point is clear. There are two locations, their IP is never put automatic. One is the router port, this is the FA0x10. And another is the server in your network. Any server computer is there. So their IP is never automatic. Either you can say never via the DHCP. It is always put manually. So definitely if I only put this only command, so all IP from 1 to 254 is given anyone. But some port like FA01, in the router port and server, some IP require reserve IP and put manually. So in this case, we can fire another one more firing command, IP, DHCP, excluded address from 1 to 15. Meaning of this line is continuation of the this configuration. We fire the last in the last one more option, 192.16.1.1 to 15. Meaning of this line, key meaning of this command is very simple. If from 1 to 15, router not allotted IP to any user. So in this case, now network manager in the mind, I have reserve IP from 1 to 15. Manually we can put this IP in your any computer, server, either router port. So now, Holika, just now tell me now what is the problem in this router? What your issue now?
Sir, I did this everything, sir. While sending mail from PC0 to PC2, I couldn't send it, sir.
PC0 to this PC2. Okay. So this is not communicate, huh?
Yes, sir.
Okay. So this is the issue of not DHCP. This is the issue of the routing protocol. Okay.
Okay, sir.
Again, repeat, if I want to communicate from own location to outsider location, so what is the procedure? There is the routing protocol. In our session, we discuss two types of routing protocol. One is the static routing protocol, another is the dynamic rerouting protocol. Okay, so you can use either any one of the routing protocol. So in my this project last session, routing protocol, we just allotted the router RIP. So he check again more. Just if you are also firing in your computer, go to the router, show running configuration and test any problem. Where is the problem? So just here DHCP services, okay, no problem. And now checking the routing protocol. Just press enter. 0x0, this is the port number as per planning 3.1. This is very nice, no problem. Then 01, this is 01. IP allotment, this is also okay. Already you done, no problem. And then after routing protocol, just you check routing protocol. Here routing protocol in this my router is router RIP version 2. There are two network, 1.0 and 3.0. So here just firing two network. In the same time, it may be possible if you are firing this routing protocol, but in the same router already one more static routing protocol already applied. So before going this new routing protocol, you can only one rule is possible. So definitely old static routing protocol first remove. So hopefully, yeah, maybe probably in your router, you have now two different routing protocols. So just firing and check this, okay? And this go. So you check from this router, this is the 1.0 and 3.0. So this is the complete status of my this router. Same manner, you check ISP router. Go to the CLI. In this case, enable. Again, here the firing enable, then go by check here also by the show running configuration. What is the configuration in this router? So in this router, I think, here the DHCP server, not allotted any directly DHCP through the router. DHCP is here separate. So definitely in this router, we have allotment of IP is showing here. And which routing protocol is showing here? So we have you two. So just now here, check now. Just wait now. Are you getting my point? Yes or no, Kalika?
Yes,
can
sir.
You, can you check your in router? Okay.
You yes, can. Sir. I'll check and say, sir, afterwards.
You can check any problem. So you just can. This video is the because you are have the same router, same types of configuration in my video. So definitely each and everything is the similar. Here just enable. Now show running configuration in the ISP router 0x0. This is the port 3.2. I am right. 0.1. This is the 2.1. This is also okay. And one more thing in this my router routing protocol. Router RIP version 2. Okay. So here only three thing is in this my routing protocol. DHCP by the DHCP server, okay. So this is now in my network is okay. So same manner you check in your computer, in your project, everything is very going well, yes or no, okay. If any problem is continue, so next time you can share your screen and discuss again, okay. Now in the today session, we go for the DNS, okay. Automatic allotment of IP issue is not na? Velika, just one more question for you. Automatic allotment of IP, that means the DHCP. So you are here in my computer, in the laptop, just I hear automatic clicking on the DHCP. So here IP automatic lot. It is working, yes or no, in your computer?
This is only not coming for me, sir. There comes a DHCP is IP requesting failed, sir.
IP addressing fail?
Yes, sir.
In this router, LTTC router?
Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
So you check now, no? By firing this command, you check here in your show running configuration and check here ki in your configuration, this facility is available, yes or no? First you check. If it is available, so that means ki there is nothing, any problem, some other issue. Definitely such types of option ya configuration is not showing in router. Please check.
Sir, now I couldn't check, sir. I'll check after the class. And
just go to the enable privilege mode, and this is the command. So running configuration for the testing and firing, and press enter and enter button. So you just check this such types of mechanism is showing in your PC, yes or no? Are you now testing? Test okay this time? Are you checking now?
Sir, I couldn't work now because my sister is having my laptop. She's working with the system, sir.
Okay. So you now check now. First, definitely check and check this point. Okay. Yes, yeah, no. So first, don't worry. First, we complete this session. Okay. DNS server. Okay. So then we again, one by one, all are repeat this configuration one by one. Okay. And if you are able to tomorrow to your laptop, either your computer connect to the internet directly, I make each and everything one by one. Okay. There is no problem. Okay.
Directly,
okay, sir. Okay, directly. So it will be repeat all of you and easy to learn what we going now. Okay. So now in the session, first we complete today. What is our session today? Today in my session, this is the DNS. What is the DNS? DNS. Okay. So DNS. Technical name and full form is very simple. Some domain name, server, sometime somebody tell domain name, service, somebody tell domain name, system. All name is valid, there is no problem. Every name, all name is as per requirement, you can use each and every name. Okay. So this is a technical name and full form. Either you can domain name server, domain name service, domain name system, all are applicable. There is no any doubt. Okay. The another name of the DNS in the critical field is the Internet Telephone Directory. Another name of this DNS is known as Internet Telephone Directory. In the old time, there when anybody installed telephone at home, landline, earlier landline is the most popular. So after installation, telephone department provided one telephone directory to the customer. In the telephone directory, there are two options. One side is the telephone number and another side respective telephone number, owner name and their address. If you have any telephone number and you dial earlier one very important number 191, like today telephone number like 100, this is the police number. Okay. 101, this is the ambulance. Okay. So in the earlier time, 191 and 161, two most popular number. This is the inquiry of customer. Okay. So earlier time, if you have a telephone number of your mate, but you have no address of that telephone person, so just you dial 191, either 161, there is a customer care representative. If you provide telephone number, so he give the information, this telephone number related to the that person and address of the that person, okay. Telephone directory, there is only two things. Either you have a name, suppose I come in your city and I have only your name and I know ki you have one landline phone at your home. So I just dialing 191161 and just telling ki this person name is Helika and I want address of her. So definitely same name, a lot of customer is possible. But in the old time, maximum 5 to 10 customer is possible. So just he provided first in just a basic idea in which location you live, and they will be informed to ki it may be possible ki this 3 or 4 telephone number of Helika name related. So you can directly dial each and every one number and find out at your desired person. Okay. So in the telephone directory, only two things. So in the same manner. And the two-day communication system, nobody communicate directly by the IP address. Because it is not easy to learn anyone for the communication, I put IP address. So how do we communicate each and everyone? Through the website address. Nobody, again I repeat, it is very similar and very simple. Communication is depend on IP address, but in the real world, normal people not use any IP address directly for any types of communication. How do they communicate? Either email ID, either the website address. Okay, so definitely in the our local network, suppose I put any IP address. Suppose this is my computer. This computer have IP address, no doubt. Okay. But I want to open another server. This is suppose the web server. Okay. So web server is also have the IP address. Okay. Suppose this is any IP address, x.x. Okay. And this is suppose y.y. But if I want to open this website on your computer, so you don't put, nobody put IP address of this in my computer. They directly put the website. What is the website name of this IP address? www. Something like that. Suppose facebook.com, fb.com, icibank.com, icicibank.com. But my computer communicate only IP address to IP address. In the meaning is very clear, in your computer, one mechanism is available. When I putting IP address, so you just go to that person, that server, he just tell me what is IP address of this website and find out the website address, IP address, then go for the further communication. So such issues solved by the DNS. DNS is nothing. In the DNS, only two things like telephone directory. One thing is one side is the IP address and another side is the website address. So any normal people just put in the web browser www.facebook.com. So just my computer, go to the DNS server first, and DNS server just across the website, what is the IP address provided, and then my computer go for the outside our network and go to the other location. So definitely in the world, communication is only possible by the IP address, but if normal people never directly put IP address, he just only remember name of the website address, because one human easy to communicate, easy to work by the name. So one mechanism in our network is available that work is only what is the website related to what IP address. Yeah, what IP address of the concerned website desired by the user he provided, and further my communication, my computer go that website. So this is very simple, and this is a DNS server is also directly work by the router. But in my this job ad, I just make a separate computer for the DNS software, like DHCP. DHCP is automatic allotment of IP. DNS is the resolving IP address to resolve concern website address, yeah, IP address to resolve concern desired email ID, like this. Okay, I just go for a practical. In this my computer, this is a DNS server. Same manner as like DHCP, you purchase the software from the software developed company and install in your computer, and working up DHCP is by default start. Same manner in the DNS, DNS software is also purchased by the concerned company and installed in your PC. But only minimum configuration will be required. So just click on this computer. Now the go to the service, and here DNS service you can may on, no problem. In there, in my this network, one web server is available, website put. This is a 2.15. So suppose in 2.15 www.facebook.com. Okay, and what is the facebook.com ID IP address? This like this 192.168.2.15 and add. So in the DNS server, only record of the IP address, the concern website address. Okay. Now just click here. In my computer, in the tablet, if I want desktop, first I check communication is working, yes or no. This is working and this is the working. Okay. Both are working. For my tablet IP address, this is a 2.10. okay, so if I go to the web browser of this my tablet, I want to open www. Suppose in my DNS server we have only one record, www.facebook.com. other record is not available. Suppose I type www.kksy.com, yeah, suppose I type helika.com. okay, so my computer, in this case this tablet, just because in this tablet DNS server IP address is given 2.10, so my this tablet first go to the this DNS server check their record, ki what is IP address of helico.com. if available, so inform ki what is IP address, suppose this IP address. So just go to return back, and they come go to the this web server, and web page is open in your tablet. So this is the path. Again I repeat, suppose I type any website, so my tablet, there is one option is available, their DNS server address. So this my laptop, go to a this my server, and this server resolve what is the IP address and find out about the concern IP address, go back and open, go to the web server and open this tablet. But in my record, if in the DNS server we have only one record, facebook.com, nothing other. Okay, so suppose if I want to helica.com, I just go, so just my computer tablet go to the DNS server. What is this? This name is not available, host name is not resolved, just return back, base is not open. But if I type here www.facebook.com, okay, so this page is open, because in the record it page is open. Okay, so now what is the DNS? DNS is nothing. Without DNS, normal user can't communicate any website. So in the my real PC, just click here, this is the my real PC. I open go to the network and sharing center. Okay, in this case. But now, Lani, this is the IP address, first two lines, no problem. This is the gateway, is also okay. Now my DNS server, in my case, router port, I just make DNS server. So this is the main DNS server. Now, what is the meaning of the alternate DNS server? Okay. You see in my job ad, there I put www.facebook.com and web server IP address. So it is very clear in the local level, in the world, a lot of websites is available. A lot of website is available. But it is not possible that millions of website record is available in my own local DNS server. In this case, we just required alternate DNS server. Again, I repeat, in the world, millions of websites are available, but in the local DNS server, your own network available DNS server is not possible. Whole world website address and their IP address. So in this case, alternate DNS server or facilities required. So here you can put any DNS server of the world, you are completely free. In the definitely some DNS server, you are also aware. And if you are not aware, so I just write, if everybody know in the world, the most biggest search engine is the Google. So Google is the big DNS server is also make. So he have different DNS server across the different location of the world. And their ID is the 8.8.8.8, 4.4.4.4, 8.8.4.4, 4.4.8.8.8, up to 12 number of DNS server of Google available. Suppose I typing helica.com in the my local DNS server, that helica.com is not available. So it help of the alternate DNS server, go to the any alternate DNS server. Here I put the Google, no problem. Otherwise, ISP also have the DNS server. BSNL also have the DNS server. Reliance Jio also have the own DNS server. So just go to the that DNS server. Please provide helica.com. If there is available, so they give the IP address and automatically my computer record that record also. So next time helica.com, if available in the world, so definitely by default, due to the software facilities, automatically memorize in your own local DNS server. Okay. So now what is the DNS? DNS is nothing. It is the mechanism. Any website, any computer, you can open. Okay, so DNS server is nothing. It is a mechanism. It helps normal user. What is the IP address of the concern, either desired website he want to open. So suppose my in this laptop, here is I just put DNS server not only in the own network, it is another network is possible. So this is the not my computer. Here you can put 192.168.2.10. This is the DNS server from this PC laptop. If I want to here open browser www.facebook.com. In this case, what happened? Because in my laptop, the last option DNS server is also given. So this is a 2.10. So this my laptop first go to the here 2.10. Find out IP address, then open this, go to the this concern website and open the web page and put open in your laptop. So now check the communication is yes or no. Yes, this is okay. So now just click here and go. This web page is open. In the PC0, there is no DNS option is I given by me. what happen in this case, you can also check. Suppose here www.facebook.com. This is not open and my computer is confused. What is this? In this case, if here DNS server option is available, the host name unresolved information display on your computer. But in this case, my computer, there is no DNS option. So my computer always confused. What is this? So he just wait. Nothing, any message showing here. Either you can say request timeout only. So now this is the DNS. This is the complete networking part. I just conclude every networking part. Tomorrow, Helika, you are ready laptop. And again, one by one, each and every done very fastly. So in the, again, I repeat conclusion and same will be repeat tomorrow. In the network portion, in the campus, either any location, if you are facilitate your campus employees, user through internet by the Wi-Fi, either any other manner, so definitely one router is required. This is the router. And this router expands in the locally via the help of the switches and help of the Wi-Fi. You can locally distribute. Okay. So now in this case, definitely router port IP address must be allotment is the manually via the go to the CLI mode and concern as per your planning allotment of IP in each and every port. And next, in the local, all computer IP address may be DHCP. Okay. And I want to communicate from one location to another location. Definitely routing protocol required. And one more thing, DNS service is required. Okay. So this is the minimum requirement of any campus, the allotment of internet, each and every device. Okay. So now, Helika response me, ki, can you do again it again? Yes or no? Are you there?
Yes, sir.
It is possible you try and tomorrow your laptop is ready for the sharing mode?
Yes, sir. Tomorrow I'll try and tell you, sir.
Okay.
I'll share it tomorrow.
Okay. You either any out of four, anyone can possible. Okay. So same time we can discuss what is the problem. So this from DNS, this is the last part of the networking. Now you're starting the security part. Okay. So first we one more addition in your course, digital phone also. So how to make digital phone? So first we go for the digital phone, then we go for the security concern. So now you have the three or four maximum possible lecture, because your lecture is daily going on. So you are 2 or 3 days past your other batch. Okay, they are starting last 2 days ki this configuration. Okay, so now any confusion, any questions, you can ask. Otherwise, tomorrow again repeat this practical from your laptop. Okay.
Yes, sir.
Okay, theek hai. Then, thank you.
Thank you, sir.